Hey everybody, welcome back to Nuclear Thrones. So today what we're going to do, I said I would explain some stuff about the game, how to, you know, maybe loop the game, how to get from the start to the finish, how to play, maybe things that could improve your game. I don't know, like, I didn't really think about planning out here are five things that will make you a good player, as BuzzFeed kind of shit. Like, I'll just do a run, and we'll just wing it, and whatever comes, I'll explain as it's going. Because that's how the game works. You have to work with what's there. There are a couple of things you can do beforehand. What I would say is, in your settings, go to video. And if you have troubles with the game, if the game's hard, if you feel that the game's difficult, you're being troubled by the game, turn your screen shake down from 100 to 50. If you're still having trouble, turn it down to 0. Lower screen shake means you can focus more on the individual parts of the screen without it shaking about. I like screen shake though. I would play with 100, but people complain about it. So for video's sake, I put it to 50. And it helps. It does actually help quite a lot. Your freeze frame value, honestly, I think is probably better set high. Because it gives you more of a chance to react when a lot of stuff happens at once. When a lot of stuff happens, the freeze frames kick in and it kind of makes everything slow down a little. And it can help you decide which way to move, which is an important thing to note. Other settings really don't matter. I mean, your control-wise, you want to keep to whatever you want. I would say that keyboard and mouse is easier than gamepad. People prefer gamepad. You can still easily beat the game with a gamepad. I say easily, quotation marks. You can do it. I've done it. Many people have done it. I know people that can beat the game in 7 minutes with a gamepad. You can do it. It's not a thing that you should be worried about. Otherwise, I don't think there's anything here. Maybe keep boss intros on. That can help you decide what you're wanting to do as it happens. The tutorial, I mean, it exists. It's a thing. What I'm going to do is I'm going to play as YB. So you'll probably have a rough idea of who your favourite characters are. I'm not going to go too much into the building of your favourite character, because you may want to do a melting Ultra A. You may want to do a YB Ultra B. You might want to do a steroids double weapon run. You might want to do like a rebel, lots of allies. You might want to do the rogue sharp teeth blast armor. You know, it's up to you. I'm going to do YB because he's a popular character and he's kind of like the game's thing. You know, it's Fish and YB are the two big characters of the game. So we'll do a YB run. And I'm going to start with the revolver, just because it's the starting weapon you would have if you get YB. YB is unlocked by going to the mansion with any of the characters you've got unlocked. Not the hardest thing, you just take a screwdriver, hit the car, go into the car, you will then unlock YB. We'll do YB. So you can pre-think what you want to do in your run. So you can say, I want to do like a YV Ultra A or Ultra B. Now this is stuff that you probably won't think if you're just beginning to play the game, because you won't know what those things are. But YB's benefits, the thing that YB does well, is he shoots things fast. He has a higher rate of fire than the other enemies, and when you right click, you're active, you shoot double at once. You shoot two of the thing at once, double the projectile. So if you've got like, say, a super crossbow, you'll shoot five at once if you right click. The throne butt, which boosts his active, will double the ability yet again. Or it will shoot three for, you know, it will shoot three. No, wait, four. It doubles again, I'm pretty sure. But if you go with the Ultra B, the Ultra B is basically an upgrade to that ability. So it's an upgrade to your right click. So you shoot five or three or five, whether you've got thrown butt or not, for one less the cost. So it's cheaper, more ammo efficient, really. But we'll get into that later on. So aye, bandits. There's a lot of bandits here. It's a lot of nuts. Bandits are fairly drunk. They don't really shoot, you know, fairly well. They kind of have a rough idea of where you are, but they'll shoot randomly. When you get a feel for that, you know, they're not too bad. They'll take a couple of bullets each to kill. You want to be grabbing those rads, you want to be leveling up. As far as enemies go, your bandits are probably the least threatening. Bandits and maggots are not really a big deal. Wrench, we'll take. We'll grab the bullets. Now, you can miss two red chests, and you'll get on the third level, you'll get a big red chest if you want. That'll give you more weapons. A lot of people like to do that in the early game. To be honest, it doesn't bother me, because the weapons that I want tend to happen after you loop. Shoot your props! First big thing that I'll say is when you enter a level in a situation like that, or even if you just see props, just shoot them. Like cars, whatever they are, as long as you're not next to them to explode, just get rid of them straight away. Normally what you'll do is you'll kill the enemies near them. He was a little bit further away. You'll kill the enemies near them, and you know, it's good for you. It's good for your own morale. Because cars can explode and kill you, you know. It can be bad. You'll always see me shooting cars, regardless of the situation, because the biggest lesson I can give, don't worry about ammo. Don't care about ammo. Don't, like, In the early game, don't worry about it, because the game is designed as such to give you ammo. So if you go low on ammo and you kill a thing, you will get the ammo. If you're even extra specially worried about ammo, take rabbit paw, because it's really good. Of the mutations we see here, there's one that immediately comes to mind is something that I want. And that's trigger fingers. Trigger fingers kills lower your reload time. So if you kill a thing, the next bullet you fire, the next projectile you fire, will fire quicker. Basically, you'll fire it quicker. So if I've got like a crossbow and I kill an enemy with a crossbow, I reload quicker, I can fire quicker. It boosts your rate of fire, basically, on an individual shot basis. And it's really good. It's especially good with YV, because we're going to go with a particular build with YV that involves shooting lots of stuff at once. So we shoot lots of things at once. The reload would usually take like 8 minutes or something. I don't know, half an hour, fucking 69 years. But we kill things, thus reducing that reload time, and it'll be back to probably faster than it normally would be. That's what we want for this. Now, impact rests is very important for the very late game, after you loop. It's a very good mutation. Don't let anyone tell you otherwise. Rabbit paw solid. Patience, you would take it if these sucked. It'll give you a reroll, basically, and on the next portal, you'll get the same... You'll get a choice, but of different mutations, basically. But we're gonna go trigger fingers. I hope I'm being clear with what I'm trying to say. I hope it makes sense, because to me, I'm bad at explaining things. I'm trying my best here. I'm very bad at explaining things. But yeah, we're just going to walk in and kill the enemies as you see them. You know, I mean, that goes without saying. You want to shoot the stuff. You want to shoot the enemies. Bandits, not very scary. Scorpions can be a little scarier. I picked up a grenade launcher, only because it shoots a high impact grenade. That's useful, shall we say. But it can also blow you up, so be careful. But I'm sure, like, you can get the shooting and the stuff down. Again, props. Things that can get in your way, get rid of them. Because if you're shooting a grenade, I'll show you what happens. Show you what happens. Maybe I won't. Maybe I will. Yeah. They blow up grenades. So if you're standing here and you think, oh, I'm just going to shoot Big Bandit in here. Boom! Blows up in your face. That's no good to you. So Big Bandit does his thing. He shoots a very inaccurate stream of bullets. And he runs towards you. Just take your time. Keep him on the screen. Hide behind a bit of cover, but not too close to the cover. If you're right here on the cover, he'll just basically run through the cover and run you over. You're dead. Instant death. Keep an eye on him. He'll shoot. You hide while he's shooting. The minute he stops shooting, peek out. And that's when you can get your shot in, because he will never charge as he's shooting. That's just not a thing he'll do. He does one or the other. He'll shoot or he'll charge. When he's shooting, hide behind cover. Come back out once he's finished. If you're extra specially fucking nuts, what you can do is you can try and cheese him. And there's a method, I don't know if it's still in the game, so don't quote me, but there's a method to get him to not attack at all, is if he spawns in the level and you're right next to him, you just stand, keeping him on the screen. If you don't break line of sight with him, he should just be docile the entire time, which is very strange. But don't try that, just kill him, the hiding and then getting out again, way, it's much easier. Right, things, scarier face, it'll reduce enemy HP by 20%. So they'll lose like 1/5 of their health. That's very good, that's very strong. Bloodlust, you gain 1 HP per every so often kills. So if you kill a thing, you might get 1 HP back. It's very strong, especially with YV. Sharp teeth. Nah, it's good, but it's not my fave. And laser brain is my fave. I love laser brain. It's so good. It effectively doubles the damage of laser weapons. It makes your energy sword twice the damage. Or at least it swings the energy sword twice. You get twice the arc. So it'll do twice, so effectively double damage on energy weapons, thereabouts. Sharp teeth can be good. Bloodlust is just really good because we'll be killing a lot of stuff and we'll need health. So when we get to the late game, we'll take damage. Always gonna happen, you'll always take damage. But the Bloodlust will, as we right click and kill a lot of things at once, basically fill our health up straight away. And honestly, in the early game, if you're struggling, what you'll be looking to take is strong spirit and probably rhino skin. Stay away from, in the early game, honestly, stay away from the likes of things like eagle eyes, stay away from gamma guts. I mean, gamma guts can be good, but like, gamma guts begins good. So gamma guts starts you good for the first like 4 levels, right? And then you get to say the frozen city, then the palace, and it's not good. It will not save you. It will not keep you going. It doesn't give you the gas you need. You want things like rhino skin, strong spirit, and probably something like trigger fingers, and just good weapons. Good weapons! Weapons! I took a laser pistol. Laser pistol is strong. Don't let anyone tell you otherwise. It does a piercing shot for like 12 damage. And if you're accurate with it, it can be fairly efficient. It's a spamming weapon. It's a weapon you want to spam at enemies. But honestly, Gamma Guts is the kind of thing that if you take it in the early game, it's good, right? You can effectively kill everything without firing a single shot up until probably here, because you don't want to walk into these guys, they explode. But after that, like, once you get into the crystal caves, you know, there's the enemies that can just basically instant kill you, the crystals. Once you get to the frozen city, you can get ran over by the... I mean, it can stop them, but then you get to the palace and it's like the big dogs just fucking jump on your head. I don't know. It gets to the point where I'm like, nah, it's not worth it to me. But there are different playstyles and different ideas, and people will probably disagree with me 100%. But, my feeling on the matter is... By the way, you don't need to do this either. I'm just doing this because I want to see what the weapon is. Because I'm being cheeky. I'll take a slugger. The reason I'm switching over is I don't have any protection from explosions. Perfect. We want this. I'll talk through. Right. Rate of walking. Your walking speed is increased. And you can walk normally on all terrain. This is actually really good. People give it a bad time, but it is actually really good. If you like to dodge, if you like to bob and weave, very effective. Again, scare your face. Awesome, but... Bolt Marrow also awesome, but Throne Butt here. So that'll effectively double our right-click ability. And the fact we have Trigger Fingers means we can do it very quickly, one after another. Perfect build. We're getting the Ultra B build that I was talking about. Again, I have no idea if this is going to help anyone, but I'm trying my dingly dangest. I'm trying my best here. Oh, hello. Watch yourself. So these enemies... The snipers are probably your hardest enemies to deal with. I've switched over here with this because a right click with that is more of an AoE than this is. And we've already got a direct damage weapon with the laser pistol. So when I do that, it washes over the enemies. Again, shoot the props, shoot the cars, get rid of them, fuck them, hate the cars. But you've got the sniper bots, they're probably your worst enemy here. The crows can be bad. They shoot three bullets at a time, and they can do it very quickly, one after another. They've got like a kind of assault slugger type situation going on. So yeah. Another thing that's important, to me at least, is priority enemies, is how I think of it. There's always enemies you want to kill first. There's props, and there's enemies you just want to deal with straight away. Snipers tend to be the ones in the big dog fight you want to get rid of. And don't be scared. Like, in this situation, I was lucky. Very lucky, in fact, because the game gave me this wonderful piece of fucking coverage. When you've got that, you know, you're like, I'm good. That's a flat cannon. I'll take that. And we'll talk about that. But that's a brilliant thing to have, because you know the snipers are here. How many did we have? We had two. There was one over here as well, wasn't there? Somewhere. I think there was one down here. I think that may have been a sniper. But as we came into the level, pop that fucker. Come up here, and you've got the cover. Just use your cover. Boom, boom, boom. And you know where they are. You know where they are because they have a fucking big red line. They point it at you. So when you see it, you're like, oh, I know where you are. So I can just keep your crosshair where they are. And then pop round. Pop round. Get them. Took the flat cannon because it's fun. You shoot a lot of projectiles at once. So Boiling Veins is really useful if you tend to explode to things a lot, which I used to do. I used to take Boiling Veins all the time because at the time... I used to die from explosions, but it was also the only thing that stopped you dying from explosions. There was no strong spirit. This is good. Bite Muscle's good with YV. You want lots of ammo to shoot lots of ammo. Rabbit Paw is what we're taking, and Recycle Gland is good if you have a bullet weapon. I tend to think it's not the best of the weapon specifics because you can always get... It basically does what Rabbit Paw does, kind of, but not as effectively. Or it does what Lucky Shot does, but not... Or a bit more effective than Lucky Shot, I guess. I'd rather have Rabbit Paw to get ammo packs more on the floor than I would have, say, you know, Recycle Gland just generate me ammo from hitting things. And it is good, don't get me wrong, it's just, it's not for me. So we just spam them down. Not really, priority enemies. We sent out a pop there for that guy, because he sucks. He can hit us with a laser that'll put us down to like 2 health. Just not ideal. Flare gun. I'll take it. I'll experiment. Never be too scared to experiment. That's another thing that's well worth noting. Don't be too scared to try other things, because for a long time, I only used, like, laser pistols. And I missed a lot of fun. Like, I used laser pistols, auto crossbows, and a bunch of other stuff. Again, run back, just hide. Fuck it, hide. What would be another good tip? Sounds! Sounds is actually really important. Everything in this game makes a sound, and you can hear when things die off screen. You get an idea of, like, where things are. So I knew there were, like, three tanks. Essentially, a little cluster of tanks here. Fire! Walk back here, you know. You hear the tanks explode, they have a sound. Make sure your sounds are set correctly. And that way, you know, I can come out again because I've killed the tanks. Also, when an enemy's coming towards you at pace, move backwards. Move out the way. Energy screwdriver is fun. What have we got? Bazooka. Terrible idea. You'll also get a feel for the way the roller bots move. So, in this area, your priority enemies tend to be golden tanks. And we're about to come towards one of our favourite bosses. Soon. I'm not taking that with me though, because that'll fuck me up. A melee weapon, even as small as the energy screwdriver, is pretty useful. It'll do a lot of stuff. Didn't destroy the car, it wasn't in my way. It wasn't a threat. But, melee can be useful against Little Hunter. That's for sure. Just gonna pop on him. Might not be efficient on the ammo front, but I was gonna say, the roller bots, they have a turning circle that's quite bad, so if they're coming towards you, just sidestep, and they'll tend to just... They'll end up round here. Sidestep and walk back. Hug walls! I find that hugging walls is very important. I see a lot of people that stay very central to the level. I like to stay on the outskirts. Staying on the outskirts can really improve your ability to not get hit by stuff. And again, don't be scared to move back around corners. Always using corners. The cover's there for a reason. It's to save your triangular ass. When it's necessary. Now you have to be quick with those guys. The corner car men. Again, yeah, okay. Priority enemies are actually the guys with cars, even though they can be very docile. They can fuck you up, but they can also be very docile. Be sure to give them a good scene too. Now, we ran out of ammo there, and I want to keep my distance. I don't want to get in with the laser or the energy screwy. He'll hit me with this car. No, he won't. Blow the fucker up. So, yeah. We're being careful. Okay, so we're at the fucking... the point of sadness. The point that everyone says this is the bit that sucks. The Little Hunter fight. So, what are we going to take? In this position, I love impact wrists a lot. But I think it's more important to take Plutonium Hunger here. Also, Lucky Shot is not bad. People will tell you it's bad. It's actually not bad at all. It can be very useful. But we're going to take Plutonium Hunger because it works with the Rabbit Paw. It's like a 1-2 punch combo that I always say. You get the Rabbit Paw, you get the Plutonium Hunger. You tend to never miss rads. And ammo! Important! Important to know. People seem to think it only affects rads. Attract drops and rads. The drops part is all we care about. The rads, fuck the rads, who cares? The drops part is the part that we all care about. The fact that it pulls in ammo from fucking miles away. Right, we need to find a safe place to be. This is not safe. Little Hunter will be here in a second. This is our safe place. Surprisingly, this is our safe place. It has walls. It has one point of attack. I'm gonna pop out and give him one of those. He will get up and fly in a second. Watch the shots. Right, he's up in the air. This is when we move. There we go, pop him with that. Stay hiding, nothing can hit you here. You're fine for the time being. Perfect, even better, he's made cover for us. Stay here, he'll be up in there in a second. He'll be coming into us now. Now oh no. That was very awkward, that was very awkward. That was a hard one actually. They're usually not that hard, how do we explain that? That one was fucked. But I'm telling you though, my method works, like, it has to work, because I don't die to him. I kill him more than I die to him, basically. I think I win 95% of the time against Little Hunter now, so there must be something to the method. Aye, being able to shoot him, being accurate and being fast is all fine. That's the perfect weapon, yes. Gatling Slugger, fast. Firing Slugger, one of the best weapons in the game for this stage. So let's just break that fucking down, right? So we came into the level. We spawned roughly here, I think it was we spawned. We spawned here or here, so I think it was here. I think it might have been here, actually. Anyway, we spawned, right, there was like a car somewhere. We killed the car, there were tanks. We killed one tank on the way up, potentially. Plus a couple of roller bots. And then he began to fall in as we started killing things here. I just had a look about us. I seen a corridor. Corridors are your friend. You might not think so. I seen a corridor. I thought, fuck it. We'll go up here and we'll wait till we hear him. And the reason we say that is that once you hear him, you know he's going to be coming in to near where you are. If he can't pathfind to where you're standing, he'll probably end up out here like he did. At which point, just fucking stand still because he's not going to peek the corner and be like, aha, I've got you now. He won't do that. He won't do that. So you can just stand here and let him spawn IDPD. Fuck him. Don't panic. Just stay fucking calm. The minute you come back out after he's flown off in the air, this is when you can start picking off the IDPD and looking for somewhere else to go. Because you assume he's going to come in here. He didn't do that time, so I just went back in. Luckily, the police spawned in here, which gave me perfect cover against them. But, you know, he decided to come in and things got a bit hairy. And just stay calm. Stay calm, and I was popping my weapon at him whenever I got the opportunity. It wasn't ideal. But you want him dead as soon as possible. The longer he's alive, the worse he is. And we didn't even get to use the energy screwdriver. Not once. If he had landed right next to us, you just spam next to him. Spam in a kind of... almost like a crescent shape. Because the fire will get you, basically. And the bullets and stuff, you want to take as much out as possible. So I tend to spam in like a crescent just around me. Like an area around me, just to protect myself. But after you start practicing, you know, the whole hiding stuff, and you start getting it down, knowing what he'll do, where he'll be, you know, you'll be fine. You'll get it. It takes time. But I still think the method holds true. I should try and develop the method further, you know. Hammerhead is really good for the fight, though. If you get Hammerhead, you can make your own cover to hide from him, and that's, you know, worth more than I can say. In the labs, your priority enemies are everywhere, everything. Mostly the plants. This is a bad labs, worth noting. The red plants that explode are really your enemy. If you've taken Boiling Veins, they're not that bad, because you're prepared for them. Also, check for mimics. You want to kill these guys as well. They're scrubs. I'm going to take the plasma gun over the energy screwdriver. No, I'm not actually. Yes, I am, because I can pop it. One thing YV cannot pop, one thing he cannot right-click on is melee weapons. They don't double up. And again, use the cover. Just peek out, shoot twice, use the cover, get back in there. Right, okay. So a couple of choices here. Lucky Shot, I said, was good, but we have the Rabbit Paw, so it's not necessary. Lucky Shot's like, if you don't have Rabbit Paw, and you're on your ninth mutation, and you don't have any ammo mutations, you're like, I should take Lucky Shot, if it's there. We don't need it, though. So there's no need. Euphoria can be good. It slows enemy bullets, gives you more chance to react. I think I go through phases of whether I prefer this or luck or extra feet to dodge. I think extra feet right now is better, but you know, I'll probably change my opinion again. Stress is cool. Higher rate of fire as your HP gets lower, probably easier to understand than trigger fingers, but I don't think it's as good as trigger fingers in my honest opinion, because I tend to always be at full health or dead. You know, you don't really get the in-between for long enough. And scarier face, less enemy HP. Definitely scarier face. I also don't believe in tier lists of... I'm just gonna pop those out there. See what we get. I don't believe in mutation tier lists. I believe in what's applicable to the situation. For instance, if I'm like mutation 8 or 9 and I don't have trigger fingers, then I might think about stress because it does a fairly similar thing. Doesn't mean one's better than the other, it's just a preference thing. Some people actually prefer stress, they just think it's, you know, it's better to have the constant high rate of fire on every shot. Because it can be nuts, it can be fucking nutty. Priority enemies are dogs. In the palace, you want to get rid of the dogs. Any dogs near you are what the big problem is. Even the exploding guys can be dodged. You want to get rid of the dogs ASAP. I didn't know he was a mimic, but I had an idea. They have a different kind of shadow under them or something. I don't know. But we're getting there. Wow, is this 24 minutes already? I've explained a lot of shit, man. I didn't expect this to be this far in. We're, you know, only on the lab. I mean, this is specifically for all the newbies. And the people that are, you know, struggling with certain aspects of the game. But practice, man. Practice is your main thing. I'm going very fast against these enemies only because I have two good weapons. In terms of weapons now, there is a subjective area to some weapons, but there are like some straight up cold hard, this weapon's better than that weapon stats. Like, I would say auto crossbow, Gatling Slugger are two of the most efficient weapons in the game. Even the Hyper Slugger, I mean, you might not see the Hyper Slugger if you don't loop, but the Gatling Slugger and auto crossbow are two weapons that you should probably use if you find them. Regardless of your preference to weapons, like, if you're having a hard time getting into the game and getting far, you should be taking these weapons, in my opinion. They're weapons that you should have, because they're really good. They'll help you improve. So, as our eighth mutation, some stuff. We've got Last Wish, which serves two purposes, really. It's a, I'm going to die, so let's take Last Wish and not die type thing, and it's a, I want to go to the jungle. I'm not going to explain what that second part is. You're going to have to find it for yourself. If you already know, you already know. Open mind is fun, and I'll explain why. Stress, we've said, Lucky Shot, we said. So open mind gives you a third chest in YV's Ultra Mutation, so I'm going to take it just for that, because it's fun. We don't need the other two, typically. Lightning Cannon. We're absolutely going to switch the Plasma Gun for the Lightning Cannon. The Lightning Cannon is fucking nuts. We don't even need to touch them yet. We can get one of those chests once we finish the throne. No. We'll start with the Lightning Cannon. I was going to say I'll switch it back to the Plasma Gun to explain, but the Lightning Cannon should be fine. So you're at the throne. You've made it this far. You have no strong spirit. You've got 8 health. Things are scary. But you're going to be confident because you can do this. You've got it in the bag. You know you have. All you need to do is stay calm and dodge well. Throne has a couple of different attacks, as the beam. The beam will always be down the center, and it will usually proc or trigger when you're in the middle of the carpet. It has the crisscrossy bullets and the straight bullets, and then it has the big balls. If you want to loop, you want to destroy the generators, and your Gatling Slugger is a bro for this. That's why you like the Gatling Slugger. Oh, hello. You won't be pulling dodges like that in the beginning, I'll tell you that for free. I usually don't pull dodges like that. That was just a lucky fucking negotiation through the ship. Practice, my friends. Practice is what gets you there. Now, you'll learn where the bullets go. They tend to go in a... Oh, fuck. Don't die, though. Ah! Ah! We're fine. I'm gonna pop that, and it should maybe do the damage that we need. That's why freeze frames are good. Oh, no. I'm dead. I'm not dead. Dead, not dead, everyone! Remember, dead, not dead! Very important lessons, dead, not dead. Okay, that sucked. That sucked for a number of reasons. It always sucks. You just have to just be fast and aware. The throne fight can fuck you. It fucks me. Okay, we have a couple of get-outs here. So, Euphoria, I've explained, Lucky Shot, I've explained. Shotgun Shoulders is really good. For ages, I was like, shit, don't take it, but it's actually really good. With pellet-based shotgun weapons, it's really good. Slugger weapons, like, I've got the Gatling Slugger, maybe not as beneficial. What it does is it means your shells will bounce further. They've got more pace and more range, which is important to note. If you hit a wall, they'll bounce. Pretty cool. It's pretty cool. You can get some mad kills with it. But Rhino Skin. We need Rhino Skin because we're going to die otherwise. We've got no Strong Spirit to protect us. And I've not explained what Strong Spirit is. It's basically like Holy Mantle. But, yeah, it's Holy Mantle, basically. Holy Mantle that recharges once you get back to full health. So if you know Isaac, if you know Rebirth, you know Holy Mantle's an item that in a particular room, if you take one hit, you don't take any damage because of the Holy Mantle. It's still there. It procs after one hit. So basically, Strong Spirit is like, once you take fatal damage, it procs your Strong Spirit, preventing you from death, and you can only get it back by going back to full health and being on the next level. If that makes any sense. We don't have it anyway, so fuck it, who cares? We're gonna take Rhino Skin, because more health means less chance to die. Priority enemies, shielders. Do not shoot the shields. Do not shoot the shields with sluggers or big old lightning plasma balls or any- oh, fuck. Terrible shot. We're just going to spam them down. So Throne 2 sucks. Throne 2 is worse than Throne 1. And if you struggle with Throne 1, then Throne 2 is going to get you. Oh, no. Okay. The attacks that are sent out. Big balls that explode into other small balls. that have ammo and health. The laser balls, the balls that shoot lasers out, usually in your direction, so when you hear them come in, kind of adjust your positioning a little. And then there's the bullet streams that it shoots out in a kind of triangle or... Triangle? No, not a triangle at all. Like, auto crossbow. In a star shape. Really, all you want to do is dodge that shit and shoot the throw until it dies. That's the be-all and end-all. You don't want to be there for too long. The longer it's there, the more fucking harrowing the whole thing gets. So you've looped. You finally looped and you're here. What do you need to look out for? Well, vans and these fuckers. And these guys as well, they suck. Vans will spawn on loop one. One van will spawn, usually after you kill a couple of enemies. Interesting. Super crossbow. So I picked up the auto crossbow that I mentioned earlier on, being a very, very efficient weapon. It is. It totally is. And you've seen what it just done to the level there. Aim at shit and just don't stop firing. Don't be like, you know. You can tap shoot once you know what you're doing, you know, once you've got a bit of confidence. But generally speaking, if you've got this setup, you're just gonna be like, fuck it, I'm just gonna shoot until everything dies. And, I think we'll go with the super crossbow, though. Although we don't have the bolt marrow, which would have made this infinitely better, we're not gonna take it. Right, so, we're finally at Ultra Mutation stage. We can pick an Ultra Mutation. We planned all along to take Ultra B, the free pop-up upgrade, because we've got fucking Throne Butt and Trigger Fingers. That's the two things that you want. If you're doing Ultra B properly, you want Trigger Fingers at least, and you definitely want Throne Butt if you can get it. So we're gonna do back to business. Ultra A just gives you a higher rate of fire. That's another run that we'll need to do at some point. So we took Open Mind for the extra chests in YV's Ultra Mutation. That's a lot of fucking weapons. So now we can pick basically whatever we want. If there's something we want, it'll be here. Hopefully. And the weapon that we want is the Seeker Shotgun. And I'll show you why. Now, game. You've been bad to me in the past with this. You said I could have whatever I want, and then I came and there was not the thing that I needed. I think it's done it to me again. Oh wait, hold on. Seeker pistol. I'm just picking up weapons to just kind of loosen the area up a little because it gets a little sticky. I think it's done it to me again. No seeker? This might be the third day in a row. Okay, we're going to take the ultra shotgun. Ultra shotgun, ultra weapons in general. Very strong. What they do is they use ammo and they use rads. So at this point in time, I probably cannot fire this, but I'll be able to at some point, which will be fun. And there's also Cuz. Cuz is a good guy. You press B on your keyboard. You can make him do that. You can make him do the ear horn. Super Splinter might be our choice. Because when in doubt, take something that you can use. I mean, this is sort of fun. You'll see how many it shoots if I right click. That's kind of like just a secret shotgun though. Whereas this thing will fire a lot of fucking stuff. And it'll be fun. This ultra laser pistol, also fun. I don't think there is a seeker shotgun in here, truthfully. Makes me very sad. I'm trying to look just in case, because sometimes I miss this stuff. Always take your time. You've got all the time in the world in here. There's no Spelunky Ghost. There's no vans. There's no fucking IDPD spawns. This is YV's house. Right, okay. So we're going to take the ultra shotgun for fun. I haven't taken that in a while. And the best weapon for popping, in general, are the things that shoot the most projectiles. So, the shotgun is fun because it does a lot of damage as you shoot it. Nade launcher could be good, but it doesn't shoot that many. It shoots like, what, it'll shoot 5 grenades? Whereas this will shoot 5 times, like, 20 splinters or something stupid like that. And you'll see in a second how daft that is. And it shoots it in a good spread. The spread is important. We'll take these two things. Because when you're popping stuff, you don't want to just hit one target. You want to hit, you know, several targets. So if I go like that. There we go. We shoot a couple of those out there. There we go. So that's what I'm talking about. That's the kind of that's the stuff. That is the shit right there, as they say. Hugging walls. I always hug walls. I'm not going to do Crown of Blood because the last thing you want to do if you're just starting is take Crown of Blood. If you get this far. You get this far and you're here. We'll look at the crowns, right, and we'll talk about what crowns are worth taking and what aren't. I didn't even approach that in the first run because I don't think it's worth talking about. We'll open that shit up though before the van comes. I've ran out of bullets. Grabapod doing piss all. Right, okay, so we got into the crown vault. It's fine. We're good. We're alive. We've dodged enemies. You've got choices of crowns. Usually I go for crown of blood because I like to get as many kills as possible, but there's other options for you. Crown of death, good if you've got an explosive weapon. Bad if you've got low health, but it's fine. Crown of hatred, not my idea of something that's particularly useful. So you take 1 point of damage, but you gain rads when you open a chest. I don't know if it's really that useful at all. I mean, it gives you ammo for your ultra weapon, but it's not enough rads in my opinion. Crown of Blood's more enemies, very hard but very good. The actual true hard mode in my opinion. Crown of Love, ammo chest only. Once you've got a setup, if you've got your two weapons that you want to run with, and believe me, you can pick two weapons and be like, these are the two weapons I want to use. Crown of Love is fine, it works absolutely fine, it's a very good crown to take. Or Crown of Luck, start area is at 1 HP, this is more of a challengey one. Crown of Protection, weapons can contain HP instead of ammo. It can be good, it's something that you can use if you struggle with getting hit by stuff. I'm going to go with Crown of Love though, because we're shooting a lot of stuff, so the ammo is going to be useful. And really, with the loop, there's a lot of enemies. We've not planned to deal with the maggots, which you would do with Gamma Guts or... say, for instance, you would do with Impact Wrists, which will kill all the maggots. By the way, two big bandits spawn. Pop them both. They'll die. You'll be alright. We're set up at a point where we do so much damage that we don't need to worry too much about, you know, all the stuff that spawns. You just kill things as they happen. So I'm going to pop with this twice, and it will destroy the van. Not all the IDPD mind. But we'll come in and we'll pick up the pieces. Now, the good thing about YV is there's a thing called overkill. When you're low on ammo and you kill a thing, the game will decide if you should get an ammo pack from that enemy, because it's like, you've got, say, under 20% ammo, we should drop ammo packs. If a lot of things die at the same time the game is thinking that, it will just drop you a shitload of ammo, at which point you walk in with your plutonium hunger, pick it all up and you're fine. Totally fine, you pick it all up and you've got loads of ammo. Something died out of the way. There's some weird portal spawns. Okay, you've made it this far. You're doing good. If you've made it this far, you probably don't need my advice anymore, so now I'm just going to play the game. So let's have a bit of fun! A bit of bobbing, a bit of weaving. Oh, fuck. We're fine. We're okay. So I hope that was at least remotely useful to people. I'll do more stuff like that with other characters and whatever if it is. I'll try and practice my ability to explain things, maybe even pre-think of what I'll talk about. That could be useful. Fireballers, they suck. Priority enemy number one in this fucking loop is the fireballer, because he's a motherfucker. I'm dead. I'm not dead. Prepare to pop, or pop while preparing, is what my old pappy always said. Give me the stuff. But you want to practice your enemies, you want to practice your dodging, all that stuff's really important. And stalking beating Ball Mum right now is very high. Very good. I'd be bad. Well, I mean, it will be good at least, because when she shoots those gas things, when they hit a wall, they explode. I'll try and see if I can catch it on thing again. It just explodes. It goes away. Whether that was a balance thing or whether it's a bug, I don't know. But don't tell JW, because it's good for us. It means that the gas does not bag up. So two hits with the ultra shotgun. Bob's your uncle. Fanny is perhaps your aunt. Ball guys. Lots of. And that's what you're planning for. With this build, you're planning to kill things quietly with one hit, or two hits, or three hits at most. You don't want to be spending all day. And when we find the secret shotgun, it will be good. Man, I just done like a half hour fucking run from the start of the game to the end of the game. That's nuts. That's the longest I've ever taken, I think. But I think I covered off some decent stuff. I think I covered some remotely useful pieces of information. I mean, there's nothing I'm going to say that's going to immediately make you good if you don't practice. That's just the way it is. Like, you need to play the game a lot to get good at it. You need to learn all your enemies. Learn your enemies and know what to expect. Ah. But you'll be fine. You'll be alright. You'll get it. I believe. Big time believes. I believe in your abilities. There we go. One of the good things about shotgun or pellet weapons in particular is that the closer you are, the more damage they do. So there's like a range that if you're very close, they do extra bonus damage. And that situation there, we fucked that van up very quickly. Don't even have shotgun shoulders. Well, two long episodes in 2 days. Tis the season to be jolly and all that, isn't it? Ah. Hooah! Get rid of that van straight away, and the big dog. I'll pop the big dog in the face, there we go. That's how you deal with a big dog, that is. That's how you tell him, down boy, down. You rascal. Not very good for the rads. Not very good for the rads. We need to collect more rads if we wish to kill the boss in here, but ammo-wise, we're doing fine. Oh, fuck. The problem we tend to have with the ultra weapons is maintaining the rads to fucking shoot them. At least we can maintain the ammo on this sucker. Oh man, if we had the Seeker Shotty, it would be a different situation entirely. Things would be dead left, right, and center. No fear. No fear! Take it head on. Okay, this is gonna suck, but or not suck at all. That was very easy. Wear a scarf. I forget that when you have less enemies on the screen, you know, you can do a lot more. It's not the super plasma cannon, therefore my interests wane. Although still good. Alright. All fucking right. No interest in these van people. Van people, these police give me a hard time. Not bad. So, as I said, if you get to loop, if you're this far into the game, you're probably fine. You know, you'll begin doing it regularly and then you'll be just, you know, pulling everything. You'll be doing good. You'll be doing good. And I believe everyone can. I believe you all can. You just gotta put your time in. Remember I've been trying to fucking love get out the wall, you dick. Remember I've been playing this game for over 2 years now? I've played in every fucking possible iteration the game has been in. So I know the game inside out. In terms of like the mechanics and how it works and, you know, there may be some secrets that we don't know yet, but comes with practice. It's like when you watch CSGO professionals and you're like, wow, they're so good, and then you're like, well, they've played the game for like 7,000 hours. They play like 15 hours a day. It's like, ah, yes, yes, of course. They just know more than me. That's all it is. They have practiced all of the possible outcomes. So, we'll put the alternate shotgun in here. I think that'll be a good little swapsie. So at a later point we can come in and be like, yes, I will indeed take the thing. Might do some ball farming here. Advanced strategies. These things drop ammo usually, so these are the big balls you get on the throne fight. So I might as well, you know. Did he hit a wall? That's probably enough. There we go. That'll give us enough spice to get through the next level. Little Hunter again. What we're gonna do is we're gonna deal with him by brute force. This guy must die. Okay, he's bad. Damn. Not the best shot, but that'll kill him. You gotta brute force him. We'll deal with every scallywag down here. Probably not worth the pop. Okay, which way, which way? Yeah. This is when you can feel strong. Strong and independent. Oh, fuck. Oh, I forgot we got 3 ammo. I was like, why are we getting so much ammo chests? Just because I have open mind, which is nuts with Turn of Love, I guess. So yeah, this is a very good synergy that I hadn't thought of in the past. And there's another chest as well? Wait, what? That's been like 4 chests. 1, 2, 3, 4. That doesn't make sense. Doesn't make sense at all. I guess every chest is going to be out. Why is there a 4th? None of these are mimics either. Well, it might be a bug. Oh wait, maybe it turns the rad canisters into chests? That's a strange interaction. That you wouldn't expect, but I guess it turns the rad canister into a... into an ammo chest. I accept, game, thank you for all the help. For all your ammunitions. We might see loop 2 here. We might see it, we might not, who knows. Ah, that's a lot of fish. It's a lot of nuts. Also, this guy has to die. Yep. Alright. Popping away, mate. That's what I'm talking about. There we go. Not a lot of ammo in the old, pick up the Gatling Slugger, just to deal with some of these scrubs. No. Alright, we're gonna have to start big in the palace, if we wish to get through this alive. It's gonna be tough. It's gonna be tough, but we can do it. I believe. Get your jungle bandit bollocks out my face. So again, the good old overkill, giving us more ammo than we can possibly need. Just be confident the fireball, the starshot guys won't hit you, the exploding guys. Just be, man, that's a lot of fucking ammo. Just be confident they won't hit you. If you hear them explode, you know, move a little. You'll probably be fine. Sometimes you won't be fine, but... it's just the way it is. They don't hit for that much. They hit for like 2 damage or so. You'll usually be okay. I need to kill this guy here. So as soon as he unshields... because he is an elite shielder. And he is bad. He means to harm us. He means for us to die. So the crown vault filled up, unfortunately, which caused a lot of that bollocks to happen. I guess we can farm for ammo again. Try and get a good run going. There's still one more alive. You only want one, really, to do this. Because if you've got any more than one, there'll be too many big balls coming in. Okay, perfect. We can kill him now, I think. One more? No, in fact, that'll be fine, because that'll give us the ammo we need. Full ammo. Perfect. Woo! Okay. We'll continue crying of love. Yeah, we still get one of these here. Interesting. That is a hyper slugger. That's pretty good. If we run out of rads, which we shouldn't do because the throne gives us lots, we'll take the hyper slugger, but I think we'll be fine. These will die in one hit each. Thing is, though, not very high score. We want a high score, usually, but... not a particularly high score. But that's fine. That'll change once we get to loop 2, so I want to shoot you a couple of times. This will be a lot easier than the last drone fight, just because we have more health. Fuck it, just pop it. Now, we need to remember, as shooting a single target enemy, we do not boost our rate of fire with trigger fingers. There we go. Because we're not killing anything. That oftentimes gets me, like, if you pop with a weapon, and you miss, and you're like, shit, I'm gonna die. Like, there's nothing you can do. Well, at least I got Crown of Love unlocked, that's one thing. Anyway, if you enjoyed the video, leave a like, leave a comment, leave some feedback as well if it helped. If it didn't help, let me know. And I will see you next time.